Before I joined DIY Girls, I wasn't very knowledgeable in the STEM field.
I don't think I probably would have even pursued engineering because during my senior year of high school, I was still very confused as in what I wanted to do.
I founded DIY Girls because I wanted young girls from my community to have access to STEM and hands-on making experiences, you know, starting in elementary school and continuing all the way to high school.
When I first joined DIY Girls, I was introduced to electronics, so we did a lot of art building, taking apart stereos, connecting LED lights.
I participated in the programs Creative Electronics, the Woodworking Count Twice, and the Creative Coding.
What I enjoyed most about the Creative Electronics program was the early exposure to engineering, which is the very basics like soldering, building things from scratch, and coding.
What has inspired me the most is watching my students working so hard, tirelessly, effortlessly, to address the need of the society.
The solar-powered backpack tent is a tent created for the homeless, able to resist different weather, specifically the LA weather, and it also has a USB portable charger, UV lights, and LED lights.
This year we decided to focus on renewable energy. We created an innovative biodigester. Biodigester will be taking in food waste. As that compost is fermenting, it's going to be producing biogas to use later to power a hot plate to cook.
They are young women that have grown to become great, effective communicators.
I see the young ladies who stand a little taller, more proud, who have a mindset that they can do it.
The organization and the programs were designed to empower the girls all along, from fifth grade until they graduate from college, and then when they enter STEM careers.
I see myself in the future working at a laboratory as a forensic scientist.
I want something in the field of coding.
My dream college is MIT, and I would like to study biomedical engineering.
I hope to achieve my goal of becoming a computer hardware engineer.